In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart.
For our goodnight message on this Saturday, the 29th of July, 2023, broadcasting from Lusaka, Zambia, by your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with what we celebrated today, entitled Lessons from Martha, Mary, and Lazarus. In the previous years, we have been celebrating the memorial of Saint Martha alone. But Pope Francis approved changing the memorial for Martha to include Mary and Lazarus, her sister and brother, after considering the important evangelical witness they offered in welcoming the Lord Jesus into their home, in listening to him attentively, and in believing that he is the resurrection and the life. In the household of Bethany, the Lord Jesus experienced the family spirit and friendship of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. And for this reason, the Gospel of John states that he loved them. It said, Martha generously offered him hospitality, Mary listened attentively to his words, and Lazarus promptly emerged from the tomb at the command of the one who humiliated death. These are the three we are looking at. And if we are to consider the first lesson that we learn from these three, we are to get it from their being together. That these are brother and sisters. They had no father, they had no mother. To tell us that it was a family of equals whose center was Christ. Christ was their dad. If we want to live as a united family, we must put Christ in the center. He must be the source of our strength. The other lesson that we learn is from Mary, who knew where her priorities were. Distractions are all around us. In Luke chapter 10, verse 38 to 42, Martha was so busy making preparations and getting things ready. She was missing out on what Jesus was teaching. Mary was sitting at the feet of Jesus, taking in all that he had to offer. After being questioned by Martha, Jesus calls her out for being anxious and troubled about many things. Mary is the one who has chosen the better part. There is nothing wrong with putting our faith into action by doing things for the Lord, but there definitely has to be a balance. It is easy to get consumed by doing all the right things and feeling like we need to do works for the Lord. And that's what I was stressing about in this morning's devotion. Like Martha, if we don't stop and take time to connect with Jesus by reading the Bible, praying, journaling, sitting still, etc., the works that we try to do for him almost become meaningless. We don't have to spend time trying to please Jesus. He already loves us unconditionally. Once we do begin to realize how much Jesus loves us, we can start to do works for him out of the love he has for us. The other lesson we learn is that Mary and Martha were not afraid to approach Jesus about how they were feeling. In John chapter 11, verse 17 to 37, again we learn that Lazarus, the brother of Mary and Martha, had died. Jesus had just arrived to see them, and both of the sisters greeted Jesus one after the other. They both said the same thing to him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. Verse 21 and verse 32. Neither one of them hid their feelings from Jesus. even though he is God, they were able to come to him with their honest thoughts. Jesus did not scold them or reprimand them. He reminded them of the truth and felt genuine sadness because of their loss. They didn't have to pretend or hold back their feelings with Jesus. He welcomed them. We should be encouraged when we read their story. As followers of Jesus, it is comforting to know that we are able to approach him with all of our feelings, even those that might seem ugly. When we are real with Jesus, it helps us trust him more, and we grow in our relationship with him. The other lesson we learn is that Mary and Martha believed that Jesus was who he said he was. Both sisters showed through their actions that they knew who Jesus was. Martha went even further than that when speaking with Jesus in John chapter 11, verse 22 to 27. After telling Jesus that she wished that he was there before Lazarus had died, she says, "Even now I know that whatever you ask God, God will grant you." Verse 22 of chapter 11. She knows what Jesus is capable of. Jesus also asked her if she believed that he is who he says he is. She replied by admitting, "Yes, Lord, I have believed that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who comes into the world." Verse 27. Even though she might not know exactly how things will go, she knows who Jesus is. There is power when we remember that Jesus is who he says he is. Though we have never seen Jesus like Mary and Martha have, we can have confidence when we hope in him. That makes even the hardest days easier to face. Jesus has conquered death and been resurrected. If we believe in him, we know that this temporary life is not the end. He makes a way for us, and someday we will be with him for eternity. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.